Welcome back to the PGA Chain Design. Today we are going to talk about how to make the model for this snail. It's gonna be long, so I separated this video into part 1 and part 2. Are you ready? Let's get started. Let's use the command picture to bring in the picture that I found online as a reference right there. As you can see, it is going from really small to really big as a spiral structure right there. So let's go to the top view to decide how thick this piece is going to be. So I'm gonna roughly about 10 millimeter there, and I'm going to creating a arc over there, something like that. The reason I have this arc here is because I'm going to creating a surface by using the revolve command, and we want to revolve SX is this straight line there. I want to revolve 360 degrees. Okay, as you can see on the picture too, it is about 3.5 to 4 turn over there. So I'm going to drawing at the front view, we are going to use this spiral over there. And for the spiral, we want to make sure it's flat. So starting with here, and it's about 3.5 turn. I'm making a spiral right there. And as you can see, it's completely flat to the construction plane. The next step, we are going to project this curve to the surface. The reason I'm doing that is because that allow me to creating the spiral is kind of a gradually increasing the size, and it will fitting into the structure better. Okay, so now I can delete this one, and this will be the curve we are using. So let me go ahead to delete this one as well. All right, so basically if we creating a pipe, and we can pipe it from this to small to something really big, and we can roughly get the structure like that, but it's hard to control the distance in between. So I come up the idea, instead of using pipe, I'm going to use the sweep command. First of all, the sweep to rail, we need to have two rail there, so that will be the second rail I'm creating. Ideally, I'm going to use this is a rail, this is another rail, and one is going down and the other one is turning, so it will fit into the natural structure better. So the first things that I wanted to do is to creating the cross section, and I'm going to snapping to this point to that point. I'll be really careful at the end, it's kind of turning like that, so we probably don't want that. And but because there's so many control points there, so I simply just going to use the split command and using the point to get rid of the very bottom turn over there. Just delete it. All right, so now we have something like that. Let's give it a try. We're going to use the sweep to rail, and this is the rail one, this is the rail two, and we're gonna go cross section here, and we'll get something like this. All right, and then this is really close to what we wanted to have there, but be really careful, it's kind of coming back over there, it doesn't look too good. And by the way, you have no control at the end, what does it look like? So what we wanted to do is edit up another circle, and this circle is actually will be the end that we want to exactly certain size. So that is the size we want. Make sure you have a history record, and let's do one more time. We wanted to sweep to rail one, rail two, cross section here, and make sure it's aligned with the seam and the arrow is all facing the same direction. And we got something like that. It's much better at the end. And then so it doesn't have that flare out kind of a surface. If you like this surface, you just click OK. And then if you don't like it, you feel like you need to make it a little bit bigger since we record a history, so we can keep changing it, make it bigger or make it smaller, or moving inside a little bit more or outside. All right, so that will allow us to play around or even turning into more oval looking. Okay, so you can keep changing to whatever that you like. So once you like everything, let's go ahead to use the cap command. And so we can close it, double make sure right here on the right, on the property. Make sure on the right bottom on the property, it says it's closed solid poly surface there. All right, so now we have this shape is ready. Notice one thing, when you are doing the rendering, it might be okay because you can just have that to do the render. But the thing is, when you send it out for print, that's turning into the ghost view. It's a lot of a surface in the middle. When you have something in the middle, you might have a hard time to print them because you're reading as an arrow. So the way to get rid of the middle surface, the easy way to do is creating a curve right in the middle, straight line. And with this straight line, we want to split the whole things with this straight line right there. So if I hide it half of them, that you're going to see I have a bunch of open surface there. So what we wanted to do is we're gonna pick up everybody and use the cap command, and we want to cap each of them become a solid there. So you can click on individually and make sure they all solid. The same thing we are going to do on the other side is we're gonna pick up everybody over there as well and use the cap command. All right, so now they are multiple individual solid there. We can select everybody and use the Boolean Union. So now it will get rid of the middle part and become a one single piece. And double check again, it's a closed solid poly surface. To make it look a bit nicer, you might want to creating a ball or sphere, and you want to use a diameter on the sphere and matching the quadrant to the quadrant. So that way you will drop a ball there, and if you look at the render, you will look nice as it's coming into a round end instead of an open cap. So then we only need to do is to Boolean Union one more time. So now we will have this structure. I hope you enjoy the video. And next video, we are going to talk about this really organic shape of the body and to go with the shell we made it today. If you find this video is really helpful, consider to join the membership. Click on this join button that will bring you to the membership program. Not only do you support my passion to help more people to learn jewelry design, and also you are able to watch member-only exclusive videos in the membership program. So don't forget to watch the part 2 next week. I hope you enjoyed today's video. See you next.